Hey, what's going on everybody? It's Bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can accept some user input in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you wouldn't mind, please like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Ladies and gentlemen, this is where the fun begins. In this video I'm going to explain how we can accept some user input in Python, and we do so by using the input function. And then we type in our input to the console window, but it would probably be good practice to let the user know what we want them to type in exactly. So let's ask for somebody's name. Within quotes, inside the input function, I'm going to type, "What is your name?" And now our program will wait for us to enter in some user input. So you can use your own name for this example. I'm going to type Bro. Now to submit some user input, you just type or press enter. Now you can see that my process finished with exit code 0, that means the program is done running. So we should probably do something with this value. We can actually assign it to a variable so we can use it elsewhere in our program. So to do so, we precede input with a variable like name works, name equals input, and when we accept some user input, we will assign it to this variable that we called name, and now we can do something with it. So let's print a message involving our name variable that we have. So how about hello plus name. Now when I run this program, we can accept some user input and then do something with that input, such as display a message that says, "Hello, bro." And then you can type in whatever you want for your name. Let's say I'm Dude. What is your name? Dude. Hello, dude. Now this next part is very important. When we accept user input, it is always of the string data type, a series of characters. What if we need to accept a number? Well, you can, but you can't normally perform any math on it because it's of the string data type. We would need to cast it as either of the integer data type or of the float data type. So here's an example of why we can't perform any math on a string. Let's say we have a variable called age. Age equals input, and let's ask how old somebody is. How old are you? Now, I will add 1 to somebody's age. Let's pretend it's their birthday. Age equals age plus 1. This will add 1 to their age. Now let's try and run this. What is your name, bro? How old are you? Let's say that I'm 21. Okay, we ran into an error, a type error. Can only concatenate string to string. With what I mentioned previously, we cannot normally use strings for any sort of mathematical equation or operation. We'll want to cast it to the integer or the float data type. So let's cast our user input to the integer data type, and we will surround our user input with a cast. Surround your input with a set of parentheses and precede this with int. And now we can use this user input in a mathematical operation. So let's try it, even though this won't display age yet. So what is your name, bro? 21. And our program finished with an exit code of 0. There were no problems. Now let's attempt to display this age. So I will print you are plus age plus years old. We're doing some string concatenation here. What is your name? Bro, how old are you? 21. All right, we ran into a type error again. Can only concatenate string to string. You cannot normally display a variable of the integer data type along with strings because we're doing string concatenation, we're adding strings together. We would need to convert this variable back to the string data type, so we can cast it. We'll surround our age variable with a cast. Now this is what's going to happen. We will accept some user input, it will be of the string data type, and then we will immediately cast it to be of the integer data type so that we can treat it as a number instead of a character. And then if we need to display this age, we will need to convert it back to a string so that we can use some string concatenation and display all of these strings together. And now let's try this theory. So what is your name, bro? How old are you? Let's say I'm 21. Hello, bro, you are 22 years old. Here's a situation. What if we enter a number that contains a decimal portion? So let's try this again. Let's say I'm 21.5 years old. Well, now we ran into a different issue, a value error, invalid literal for int with base 10. That means if we cast a string as an integer, it can only be a whole number, a portion that does not contain a decimal. And that is where the float data type would come in. It is a data type that can contain a decimal portion. For this example, let's create a third variable called height, and we will ask for somebody's height. Input, we'll create a prompt that says, how tall are you? And we will cast this to be of the float data type so that our string, our user input, can contain a decimal portion, and then we can treat it as a number instead of a series of characters. And I think I will delete this line. We won't really need it anymore. And then let's print their height along with a message. You are plus then height, but we need to cast this back to being a string. So we'll surround our height with a cast plus, let's say CM tall. All right, let's test this. What is your name? Bro, how old are you? Let's say I'm 21. How tall are you? Let's pretend that I'm 250.5 centimeters tall. I'm adding the 0.5 just to test to see if this will accept a floating point number. Hello, bro. You are 21 years old. You are 250.5 centimeters tall. Not really. All right, everybody. So that is the basics of user input in Python. Normally with user input, it will give you a value of the string data type. If you need to use that value for any sort of math, you'll probably need to cast it to be of the integer or the float data type. So if you would like a copy of this code, I will post this in the comment section down below. But yeah, that's how to accept user input in Python.
Hey you, yeah I'm talking to you. If you learned something new, then help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.